So the SPEAR stands for Specific Peptide Enhanced Affinity Receptor. So what we're doing there is we're taking a T cell receptor that you would find in normal people or in our libraries, and then we're enhancing the affinity. So that means we're making them recognize the peptide antigen more strongly than they would normally do. So that's the engineering part that we do at the Adaptimmune facility, and we test those then to see whether we've got increased efficacy. We then test them extensively to check their safety so that they're not recognizing other things. And we're really manipulating the immune system to be able to recognize cancer where it normally can't. So, the very fact that you've been diagnosed with cancer means that your immune system has failed to protect you at that point. So we're giving patients' immune system a new way of recognizing their tumor. And we're using the natural physiology of the T cell receptor, the way that it normally works against flu, COVID, other viruses, and we're trying to make it recognize cancer in the same way. So that's what the T cell platform is about. And we're trying to basically just boost the immune system to really tackle cancer in a way that it normally doesn't. Adaptimmune focus predominantly on solid tumors, and that's just because of the success of CARs means that the heme cancers are not a great place for us to focus on. There are several biological differences between CARs and TCRs, and some of those are around the density of antigen that they'll see. The way that they signal is quite different, and we've seen traction so far in synovial sarcoma. We're pushing forward our first program to commercialize in that indication, but we're also looking to broaden it to as many different solid tumors as we can. And that's a really important factor for us. I think TCRs are really good in some respects. There's the downside that you have to select for HLA type, but we're also trying to address that by looking for other HLAs to increase our patient coverage. But it really is a let's prove the platform in one disease, and then we'll try and get the right tests in place, try and make the improvements required to tackle as many different solid tumors as we can. So it's quite a different way of selecting patients than the CAR system, where, with CD19 BCMA, they're effectively there in every patient. You don't have to screen by HLA. But we've also got a new platform coming out called HLA-independent TCRs, which we're really quite excited about because that gives us a similar way of tackling without HLA subtyping. So our first hit, the HLA-independent TCR, is on mesothelin. So that would traditionally be a CAR target, but we're working with our partners, Astellas, on that program to prove that TCRs can work in that space as well. So that's really exciting for us.